Hey, and what is happening, guys? Yankee here. We're back for some more Let's Play Banjo-Tooie. In the last part, we basically opened up a lot of new areas with Mumbo and did some things with the van, and in this part, we're gonna do some more things with the van. Make, I think, two more deposits, and we're done with that, and I think we'll re-go to Space Zone and do this Thorcer ride, as well as the Dodge little bumper car kind of thing. And maybe we'll touch on some new grounds, not the website. Okay. So, let's actually go to the Space Zone first while it's fresh in our heads. We could go to the Inferno one, but this one, I don't know. It's just a little on the way. So, let's go to Witchy World's little... What is it called? The Dodgem Dome, I guess that's the formal name. And pay here to enter the bone-jarring Dodgem's Challenge. I'll pay for this ride. Looks fun enough. It's like a little futuristic kind of setting. I guess it is space, after all. The ride is now open! And there we go, we can now enter through here as Banjo and Kazooie, and the ride is now open. So it's a little two-parter right here. We need the help of not only Wumba, but Mumbo as well, like we saw in the last one. And let's actually head to Mumbo's area and pick up that Cheeto page, because, like I said before, Cheeto pages are actually important in this game. And I can't wait to get that full damage cheat. I know we can get the eggs one, I believe, is the next one, but... I think if you actually beep, they avoid the attack, so... I don't know, I guess if you don't want to... If you don't want to go on a murderous rampage and save the enemies, there you go. Alright, so we're done with that. We're going to deposit our van back to Wumba, and I think we're done with it. And we can't, if you go in the lava, it doesn't have any damage on it. Which is kind of cool, I guess that's why it's an armored bank little car. So let's go to Wumba, and retransform. So yeah, like I said, my plan in this part's actually to knock out two space bots, and I think I'm going to head back to the Inferno area and, tackle that green door, and he did that again. That's so weird, that little, like, I don't know, man, that's, like, possessed right there when he's, like, getting out of the tub. Ugh. But yeah, we're gonna head back to that purple and green little door area after we, deal with the space zone. I think we'll do the Dodgem's, little thing first, since that we just touched up upon that, and that's, again, fresh in our heads. So, yes, it's basically like the, Stony game, but a little different, as we will see right here. So let's enter door number one. It's a 1v1 challenge right here. We got, like, the new little bumper car, or the blue one. Leave our Twinklies alone! What?! We're Twinklies! I never even saw them in my life! Let's see you collect 60 points worth of Twinklies in 45 seconds. Whack the bear! Alright, so basically, this game is basically, to collect the, as many of these things as possible. We have to collect 60 points worth, and obviously, blue are worth 3, green are 2, and red are 1. I think I'm repeating myself in every part now, or I feel like I'll be in the rest of these Witchy World parts, because like I said before, the point system is pretty much set in stone. And while this is taking effect, and we've basically dominated the score, I actually had some nice lunch today. I had gluten-free pizza, I don't know. My parents have been really getting into that, I don't know, everyone's getting gluten intolerant nowadays. I even like how they made a joke about that and This Is The End that came out this summer. But yeah, it wasn't bad. I mean, I don't know, just... The only thing about gluten and gluten bread is that your mouth just gets dry real fast, and it's like, eh. But anyway, we beat game one with 97 points, now try the second challenge. Alright, so that story lasted one. I need two more stories, because... I don't know, the first two are easy, but the last one is a little bit of a challenge, but... You should have no problem just cruising along. Alright, so we have two drivers against us now. One's in orange and one's in black. Which one is the gas pedal? Okay. I shouldn't have anything to worry about after all in this race. Or not a race. A little bumper car thing. 50 points worth in 45 seconds. Again, whack the bear. So I had 97 points in the last run. So now we have two against me. It might be a little more difficult. I don't know why they just follow me in a straight line. They should really sandwich me in. Like that. That was brilliant. There you go, guys. I'm actually rooting for them because this is really pathetically easy. I think I got like 97 points in both my tries the first two. But the last one I think is a little tougher, so we shouldn't have any trouble with that. Alright, so we're just collecting colored Twinklies. Really nothing interesting to talk about right now. I mean, I talked about Pikmin 3 in the last part. I'm still in the middle of it. I don't really want to spoil anything, so I'm going to leave that to a minimum. I just talked about the game in general, so nothing really was spoiled, so just know that it's a really good game, and... I get, oh, I was trying to get 85. That would have been a nice little number. Hey, what's this? You've beaten game two with 83 points, but there's still my third challenge. All right, one more challenge to go, as if this wasn't repetitive enough. Last one. Little entrance number 3. And as you can see, it's 3v1 this time, so not a lot of area, so this might be a little tough. We got the black car, the orange car, and now we got the purple car. You're in for a real ramming this time, pal. Whoa! Easy there, buddy. Oh man, that's what she said. Let's see you collect 40 points worth of Twinklies in 45 seconds. Whack the bear. Whack the bear. Okay, that's just, I don't know, this sounds like a really triumphant kind of sound right there. But yeah, these things are called Twinklies. I think in Britain, in the UK, that's actually a derogatory term, I think. It's slang for, like, I think, boobs or whatever. I have no idea. Like, it's so funny because Rare throws a lot of, like, their own lingo in these kind of games. If you want to check out more cool Banjo-Kazooie facts, I would check out Thumbs Up Master's videos. He has a lot of cool ones. He has like X-File kind of things, like hidden behind the scenes things, like lots of little messages. I actually like the videos, and it actually inspired me to make the Stop and Swap video. That's right, hand it over, you bony hag! Yeah, give me my loot. I didn't have to read your dialogue to know I was getting a jiggy, because we beat your three alien minions in the Art of Bumper Cars. Yeah, it was a space-time tradition in the future. I was gonna say back in the day, but there we go, I corrected myself. And, yeah, so we're gonna teleport actually to Wild Wild West Zone, because we actually have to take the cable car across to reach the Source of Peril ride, because I don't think we can access it otherwise. And for some reason, I thought that van thing we never went in, so I kind of bugged out a little there. But yeah, I don't know why it's even there, because you can just jump off from the ledge with the van, and I don't know, I guess it's there for just for, like, want to know how to use the van. There we go. So yeah, let's experience the scenic splendor of the cable car ride across to Space Zone. Alright, so we're going to take this over to the Sorcerer of Pearl, which is actually my favorite minigame in the whole entire game. I think I mentioned this before, but it is a blast, and we'll be seeing that literally, and we have to actually just shimmy our way over here. Don't want to get electrocuted, because if it hits you, you actually lose a life, but the funny thing is, I don't think you fall down, unlike the blue thing that pops out that can attack you, so that's interesting. I guess it's a very generous electrical current right there. Good Tesla. But yes, let's activate that shock pad, in case we ever want to come back up here and do this minigame. But I think you just access it from the main menu, so I don't know why you want to play this again from here. And there we go. Interesting thing is, okay, yeah. See, that's how you open the door. I was an idiot back in Glur Gulch Mine, and it wasn't the fuel depot, but had to hit that button. Gotta hit that red button, man. Ooh, it reveals a flying saucer. Like I was saying, yeah, you see that sign over there? You cannot take the hamburgers and fries you get from this world to other worlds. That'll be an interesting little element later on. We'll have to find ways around that. Anyway, let's talk to the little guy. Bleep! Jump on board to ride the exciting Sorcerer of Peril! Bleep! Okay, I'm pretty sure he says bleep and not the action of bleep. Like, I was, it's weird trying to read things like it's like run through wherever, I don't know. Witchy World Sorcerer of Peril ride. When the crosshair appears, press LT or RT to fire at the targets to score points. Blue targets are worth 3, green are 2, and red are 1. To give you a chance, I'll give you some special eggs. Cool. And score 500 to win the first prize, or 400 to win the second prize. We've seen that before with Canary Mary. Second prize is the Cheeto Page, and the Jiggy is 500 points, so we'll definitely be wanting to win. Alright, so this is why it's the coolest minigame, I think, in the game. It's not only a tour around the whole entire theme park, but basically, it's like a little shooting range kind of thing. I just love when games have this kind of thing. And just the perspective is really cool. When you go left, Banjo actually goes left with his hands, but you don't really notice that because you're always looking at the targets, but it's a really nice touch. I don't know, man. I like it a lot, and it's really fun, too. I actually, like, this is the only minigame I would go back and actually play, just to see how high of a score I can get. So, and we actually get to go back to all the attractions we were at. And it may seem simple right off the bat, but it gets harder as it progresses. Right now, we're actually going at a slow speed, but it puts you through a lot of bumps and turns, and you have to always focus for the blue ones or the green ones. Never go out of your way to get the red ones. I know I've probably said this like 100 times because all the minigames are basically like this in the scoring system, I mean. Oh, here, here we go, here we go. Put your hands up! Okay, Banjo, you don't, you're driving. Don't want to practice unsafe driving practices, Banjo, but then again, it's a flying saucer. I don't think there is any codes to driving one. You don't need a license. Then again, why would a bear be driving? Okay. Let's get off that paradoxical argument. See, we have 184 points. We have to get to 500. I mean, you could do a second try again if you don't get to the 500. Well, actually, I was gonna say if you don't get the Cheeto page, that is the second prize. I mean, because I was getting confused with Canary Mary. That was the, you have to do that race afterwards. You can just do this in one shot. Alright, so let's keep going for the targets, and we're still, oh god, do a 360 barrel roll, awesome. Use the boost to get through. I can make so many Star Fox references right now, but I'm holding back. But yeah, I was gonna mention that 10 week pass. We're actually gonna do that, lastly, because that is where the main boss is. And we're gonna use those tickets we got to enter, because that's how you get inside, if you didn't know otherwise. And, I think I mentioned this before, but you have unlimited eggs, so you might as well use them all. And now we're going to enter the Wild West Zone with the Bounce Castle. Cool. Alright, so we only need 8 points to get that second prize, so we're doing pretty good right now. I was trying to find out how many points you should have in each area and try to, like, give you advice on that, but I don't know, this is kind of a weird thing to, like, tell you how many you should have at each point. It's just more of a run-and-gun kind of thing. Just shoot the targets, I mean. Pretty simple, right? And just rack up those green and blue ones. Look at that, we already got second prize. And it's interesting for me to note because, with this note I'm going to give you right now, is that you don't end up going back to the space zone. You actually go to Area 51, so don't think that the ride is, like, not even done yet. It's actually, this is the last stretch right here. So you definitely want to not be too conservative and rack up those points as quickly as possible. Like, right now, I need... I'm running out of time. And, ooh, I got a couple there, okay. It's kind of hard to hit those targets when he does, like, the 360 or does, like, a barrel or whatnot. Alright, we're getting close. Okay, wow, okay. I got a little scared for a moment. We only squeaked by a little. Like, look at that, 526. We barely got the jiggy. And that, I got a lot of the targets, too. I focused on the green and blue ones. But, yeah, we got it anyway. Cool. Nice shooty. You win 2 bleeping prizes. A cryptic paper thing. I didn't think he was cursing at me right there. You win 2 bleeping prizes! And the shiny gold thing. So cool, we got 2 prizes in 1. That's all my prizes gone. But why not ride again and try to beat your best score? Maybe I'll do that in my free time, but I don't think the people want to see that again. Like I said, they always want to see progress. Yes, the carousel of progress, and we got our Jiggy, that's number 29. Awesome, man. Feels like just yesterday we started this Let's Play, probably less than a month ago. Already got 29 Jiggies. I think there's only 80 in the game, so we're moving along. Moving on up. Oh, let's talk to the burger guy. I actually get a burger. Fancy a burger? Big Al sells the tastiest burgers in which world. How on earth did you get a job at catering? Well, I'm not sure really. I used to clean out the toilets. I've lost my appetite all of a sudden. Go on, give him a try. I've got a few of them left. Do you want them? I love how his, like, name tag badge is, like, a 1-star. Only kid. Okay, kid, you want burgers with that, or you want fries with that, blah, blah, blah? Oh, yes, please. Well, too bad. Burgers is all I got. Go see Salty Joe. Nice, we got a burger. What? I've got no more burgers left. Better root around for some more. I think you just got one on your left foot. Where? I can't... Oh, God. Hopefully that's not how most fast food restaurants are run, because I get fast food probably like once a week, and if that happened to my burger and I didn't know about it, I would scheme out a little. Look like I go to like Wendy's, I don't know. I think Wendy's has more of a quality control, but compared to like McDonald's and whatnot, but that's just my opinion. Hurry up and order, weirdos, I'm a busy guy. So I see, we had to fight our way through this crowd of customers you have. Quite the comedian, huh? How about some of Salty Joe's limp salty fries? Ugh! That sounded gross, and he's got 4-star badge. Wow, is that... might have some quality here. Have a nice day, I guess. I knew he would say that. Yep, me too. I love how they have, like, little in-jokes. I better start frying up some more, because we're all out. Yeah, you better prepare for the pending rush. Why, you cheeky... I'll finish that sentence. Why, you cheeky bastard! Another British humor slot right there, and, I think that we are getting close, gents, to the end of this part of Let's Play Banjo-Tooie. In the next part, I'll be talking this whole... Okay, I'm not gonna be talking that this part. But, I think we can give one of the kids the burgers or the fries. That's why... I don't know, I kinda just visited them. I wanted to save the kids for last, but I kinda visited the places just cause we had like 3 minutes left in the video. I didn't want to start anything, it's not fair. In fact, there's nothing you can do to take me. We bribe you with food? Oh, this place is great! I'm never going back to my mom. Kid! What are you, you're just walking around in circles, the mom's right next to you. Just go back, what the hell, okay. I got this kid confused. There's actually one that wants burgers. That's the chubbier, more portly of the kids. One wants fries. I know that's a daughter for a fact. And that was in the Star Spinner. So we still gotta find the fatty fat. And that kid, I don't know. Do we have to, like, beat him or something? I have no idea. I'll figure that out in the next part, though. So anyway, yes, I think we'll end it here. Thank you guys for watching. In the next part, we will be taking out the areas that we saw by the Inferno that we put off, those green and purple doors, and maybe be figuring out how to get back some of Mr. Boggy's kids, because maybe we'll deal with that now, maybe we'll deal with that later, but I know you can't get one of them, so maybe I want to deal with that later, actually. I have no idea. Let's actually look at this. No. Don't pause. What are you doing? Huh? I said don't pause, thank you, okay. I wanted to actually zoom in on this thing. The Inferno. Oh! Hey, you ruined my shot! That's how I make my thumbnails, okay. No, no, no. Oh well, hindsight guessing inside, I'm gonna call it here. So thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you next time on Let's Play Banjo-Tooie!